With that, I think your question was said here, people do not know how much we revere Islam. Nor do people know or understand how to practice Islam. Majority of those who live outside the Muslim countries get to know Islam through the media. Show me one media that has done any religion a favor. It's only now that you begin to have these specialized channels. But generally, media has never done any religion a favor. And I'm ashamed to say this. We have visitors to our country who are asking us, do you have something that I can get hold of to understand your culture, your religion, your way of life? And the only reference I can give them is what was written by others, not us. So most of the time, their reference is a perception. It is an impression of a person who does not hold the same values as we do. We have two Greek professors. They've asked me, do you have something that I can get hold of in French, in Italian? Those are two languages you understand. And if there's nothing, probably in English. How many nationalities visit us in Oman? We have from the Indian subcontinent. People who speak Telugu, Malayalam, who speak Urdu, or maybe speak Bengali, or maybe speak other languages, Marathi. People who speak Tamil. We have people from Nepal. They all say, we've come to Oman, we've seen how peaceful the place is, we've seen the manners, we've seen the way you conduct yourself, we see how peaceful you are, we'd like to understand what's the secret. Do you have anything we can get hold of to read or to understand? What is the answer? Sorry, we don't know. Now, if Muslims, you are given a message, and we know that this Quran that is with us is the book that has got the message for mankind. It complements the message of previous prophets, the message of Jesus, Moses, the message of Abraham, the message of David, Solomon. It carries the same message, and it is in our hands. What did we do to communicate it? It's a question. When you go to the West, or when you go to visit them, what values do we take with us? Or do we just mingle and try to be discreet in that society? How many people are proud of their values as Muslims? How many of them, I'll ask you a simple question, and you can choose to answer it or not. And the question is, if you truly love this way of life called Islam, and if you truly love the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to an extent that you're willing to defend openly this faith, if you truly want to emulate his way of life, if today I was to invite two people to your house, two people, think of this scenario. I was to invite two people to your house, and they were going to be with you for 1 week. So they'd go to the places you go, they'd eat what you eat, they'd conduct themselves the way you do. In other words, they're going to shadow you. You're going to be who you are, and they will be with you, maybe learning from you, or observing what you do. Of these two people, who is going to be most happy with you? The first one is a non-Muslim. And the second one is the Prophet himself, whom you're trying to defend. How much of adjustment would you have in your life if the Prophet was to come and visit you in your own home tonight? That is testing the love you have for him. How much of places, how much of appointments and commitments would you cancel because you have him with you for 1 week? How many decorations, magazines, channels, places you'd remove from sight just in case you feel that you're not complying to the way of life he's teaching you? That would give you an answer. And I'm not suggesting that to go radical in changing. What I'm suggesting is that the reactionary mode is only making more damage. We are not solving the situation. 1 week, an abruption, an eruption, and those who benefited the most were none other than telecoms of this world. What benefited the most was the media. So then they could sell stories. But after the rage, what comes after the rage? Who changed their minds as a result and realizes their mistake? I think I'm giving you a very heavy dose to think and to take deep inside you, to digest. Now the question that I have, we are in this dilemma. We want to make a living. We want to survive. We want to portray Islam at best, peace at best. I won't even use the word Islam because Islam has got a different connotation. Today, and at times I do not blame the West, when Islam is associated with terrorism, is associated with fundamentalism, is associated with extremism, because whenever there is trouble, Islam is always put there as the first beginning, and simply because of the way we conduct ourselves. What is the way out? I was asked by a Norwegian professor who was on a mission from a Norwegian government to try and find a solution, to try and understand first why such a reaction. What should the West do to heal the wounds, to bridge the gap? What should Muslims do in return as well? What would make Muslims accept as a way forward? How much of effort is required to heal the wound and to forgive and forget? I was asked that question, I'd like to ask you. Knowing what you know now, what do you think we should do, be it as Muslims? Maybe I'll ask our visitors, what do you think Muslims should do to try and clarify this misconception, or maybe promote peace, or bridge this gap? Think for a minute, I'd like to hear your answers. Okay, I'm going to take four here and four here. In the back, please, yeah? Mutual respect. We should begin to promote mutual respect. And we'll talk about mutual respect in a minute. Yeah, okay? Mutual understanding. Let us understand each other.
Yeah,
establishing a dialogue. Okay? Establish a dialogue. Mutual respect, mutual understanding, establish dialogue.
Muslims should contribute to the worldwide and cases and issues, current issues of the world.
How should they contribute?
Mostly, Muslims are behind from all those cases.
Muslims should contribute to our development.
Yeah.
Okay? It should be effective participation. Okay? Okay? Establish, for example, television programs, seminars, conferences. I get to go and clarify misconception by showing people who is a prophet. Yeah? Okay? Any other offers? Follow. State our principles and stop sending mixed signals. Yeah? State your principles. Make them clear, visible, for the world to know, at the back. Unless they change of themselves. The first change has to be from internal. We should change ourselves. Okay, two more? Two more? Two more ideas? How about from non-Muslims who are here with us? What do you think Muslims should do?
I think the question was answered earlier on.